Greetings everyone, today I will show you how to create a laser reflection in 2D. Before that, this is my mini game which I created in a couple of days. It's similar to this video, it will publish soon on Google Play and itch.io. I prepared two sprites which one of them is a circle and another one is a square. We have two platforms, one of them is a mirror and an enemy for rotating the laser. Don't forget to add a box collider 2D to platforms. And also we need a layer for our platforms, a tag for our mirror, and then a layer for our enemies. Now let's create an empty game object, an enemy, and attach the line renderer to it. The line renderer component takes an array of two or more points in 3D space and draws a straight line between each one. You can use a line renderer to draw anything from a simple straight line to a complex spiral. Change any values to get the desired one. Remember to change the material, otherwise you get the pink line. You can read more about it here. Create a script and open it. First, create a variable to get the line renderer, then add a variable to define how many reflections actually we want. The next one is how long a raycast is going to be. And a layer for raycast detection. And the last one is for the speed of our circle rotation. Inside the start method, set the physics2d.queries start and colliders to false. It is used when we want the raycasts that start inside colliders to detect or not detect those colliders. In the update method, or fixed update. The first line we call the transform.rotate to rotate our circle. Then set the position count of our line renderer to be equal to 1, this makes the first point of the line we want to create. Then set this point to the position of the circle. Next up we are going to use raycast hit 2D to store data. Then check to see if you hit something with a raycast, just put the origin and direction, and set the length of it and the layer we want to detection. These variables are used for when the raycast hit the mirror, to store the point in world space where the ray hit the collider's surface. And the normal vector of the surface hit by the ray. Make a for loop statement and set the length to reflections, this is going to loop the amount of reflections that you want. Then after that, we going to set the line renderer position count to plus equals 1, and are going to increase the vertex count each time we through for loop until we hit something. If we hit something, that means the collider is not null. We are going to set the position the last index to hit.point, which is the collider's surface. Then make the isMirror to false. Next we are going to check the collider, if it is a mirror, so let's recreate the hit info and continue the loops, but if it isn't we should break the loop. The first thing we should do is store the hit info data to these variables. Then recreate the hit info, make the origin to the point we hit, and the direction to vector2.reflect. Which reflects a vector off the vector defined by a normal. Then make the isMirror to true. Now if we didn't hit anything with the first raycast, then we just want to set the position of the last index of the line renderer to transform.position plus to transform.right, and multiply them by max distance. But it's different when we hit the mirror, because we don't know the exact location of the previous point that we hit. And the hit info variable was created again and has no previous data, we can't use it like below. So that's why we create three variables for the mirror to can have point we hit and reflect it, and then multiply it by max distance. It works great, but there is tiny problem. It is here. To fix it, add this line code. Just a simple ray. Origin is the circle position, and direction is transform.right. To decrease the distance between the line and the collider, add this code to hit.point. This works great. If you have any questions, post them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. Just for tips, if you have a lot enemy or lasers in your game, it might decrease the FPS. The best thing is to use dots, but if you have no experience with it, you can just use a base class to adjust the lasers in one for loop statement. Like I did in my game.